This video will cover the nervous system as part of the human body unit. The structures that you need to know about from the nervous system are the brain, spinal cord, and some notable examples of nerves, which we'll discuss a little later. We can divide up the nervous system in different ways. So we can firstly divide it into our central nervous system, which comprises of the brain and the spinal cord, and also into the peripheral nervous system, the PNS, which makes up both the sensory and motor pathways. So this is divided in terms of its structure and the location of the features that make up each division of the nervous system. If we look at the PNS first, some of those notable nerves that you will need to know are the cranial nerve, which emerges directly from the brain, the thoracic, which is a collection of nerves mostly in the chest region. You also have the sciatic nerve, which is the largest one in the human body that runs the length of the lower limb. And also the radial nerve, which is a major nerve of the upper limb supplying the arm. As we talk about the function and structures of the nervous system, the cells or the functional unit are the neurons. So there are different types of neurons, which we will take a look at also. They are arranged slightly differently, but will all have these same basic features. And they work on the basis of sending out electrical impulses in order for different regions of the body to be able to communicate with each other. So all neurons, regardless of which type, will have a cell body. This is where you find things such as the nucleus and the cytoplasm, all the different organelles of the cell. They also will have dendrites, these branch-like structures that bring the electrical impulse into the neuron. An elongated, stretched part, which is the axon, surrounded by an insulating myelin sheath. This transports the electrical impulse from the dendrites down through the axon till finally it reaches these other branch-like structures known as the axon terminals. And this is where the electrical impulse will exit the neuron and make its way to the next neuron within the circuit. So the different types of neurons that we have motor neurons, sensory neurons and interneurons, which might also be referred to as association or relay neurons. So as you can see from the diagrams, they might be arranged in slightly different ways, but they do contain all of those features we just spoke of. The sensory neurons, these are the neurons that are responsible for detecting the environment. This might be our external environment, the world around us, or possibly any changes within our internal environment. Those interneurons, these are responsible for processing and transmitting information within the brain and the spinal cord. And finally, the motor neuron, which is there to respond to the environment, quite often will involve the movement and the contraction of muscles. If we focus now on the central nervous system, which consists of the brain and the spinal cord, and its main role is for processing the information that's constantly coming in to us from that external environment as well as the environment within. That information is then processed with instructions given out on how to respond to any changes or any information that comes in. The brain is the major organ of the nervous system, and there are three main regions, three main structures that you need to be familiar with. We have the cerebrum, which is the largest portion of the brain. That's at the surface where it's folded, and this is responsible for all those higher brain functions, for processing information, for thinking, for planning, for memories. for all our different senses. So lots of very key functions are taking place within the cerebrum. There's also the cerebellum, or little brain, sits right at the base, which is responsible for things such as coordination and our balance, our motor functions. And finally, we have the medulla, otherwise known as the brainstem. This connects up our brain to the spinal cord and is responsible for lots of the primitive life-maintaining functions. So this is things such as regulation of the heart rate, the breathing rate, of the sleep cycle. So things that we need to stay alive. So how does our brain monitor our external and internal environments? How is that information brought into our brain? And how is that information then processed and a decision made with the instructions sent out? So anything that we are detecting is known as a stimulus. So in this example, we've got the stimulus of a delicious cooked meal. Think of all the smells, all the visual information that's coming into your brain. We have to have a way to detect this stimulus in the form of a receptor. It could be our nose, in this case, picking up on the smells. This information will be sent via a sensory neuron to one of those association or interneurons within the brain. Brain will process the information, will start to think about the smells, start to think about the food, whether or not we're hungry, and that will lead us to come to a decision of how our body is going to respond. That decision, that information is sent through another electrical impulse via a motor neuron. This will carry out that signal to an effector, which will have a response. So in this case, the motor neuron is bringing that information to our salivary glands, which carries out the response of salivation and direct response to our initial stimulus. So regardless of what our stimulus is, it will follow this basic pathway. Stimulus detected by a receptor, brought to the central nervous system, the processing centre, by a sensory neuron, processed with the help of those inter or relay neurons, decision or instruction sent out via a motor neuron to an effector, which will carry out a response. Something else that our nervous system is capable of performing are what is known as reflex actions. So a lot of scenarios, particularly situations that might be dangerous, we need to respond very, very rapidly in order to protect the body. So if we had to spend time sending that information to our brain, processing that information, consciously becoming aware and making a decision, that can actually take quite a long time in terms of our body's response, and by that time the damage could be done. If we want to respond almost instantaneously, much more quickly, then we can bypass the brain altogether and the spinal cord can act as our processing centre. So reflexes are generally protective in nature, and this is a neural pathway that oversees our response to a particular stimuli. So in this case, we'll use the example of a burning hot pot. So you've been cooking, you've got the pan on the stove, the handle is piping hot. If we were to touch that pot, it potentially could cause serious burns to our hand. So our body has to respond very, very quickly in order to protect from that damage. So this pathway will start the second contact is made with the high temperatures. So we have thermoreceptors within our skin that will detect that this pan is very, very hot, that this is hot enough to cause damage to our skin, cause serious burns. That information will be passed as an electrical impulse through a sensory neuron, which brings it directly to the spinal cord, to an interneuron within the spinal cord. This is where the information is processed and relayed to a motor neuron, carries out the instructions to the effector, which in this case is the muscle in the arm, which acts to automatically pull our hand away from the high temperature from this pan and thus preventing the serious damage. So exactly the same pathway as we saw previously, except this case we are not having to send information all the way to the brain first, we're only going to the spinal cord, and thus the reaction is almost instantaneous. So we have our stimulus, the hot pan, detected by thermal receptors in the skin. Information sent via a sensory neuron to our integrated centre, the spinal cord. Information processed with the help of a relay neuron, sent to a motor neuron, which carries out the instruction to the effector, which carries out the response of moving the hand away from the dangerous stimuli. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comment box below.